Thank you. Thank you. Those who are viewing virtually. Please respect the couple's wishes to keep your masks on, and also there will be no video or photos during the ceremony. This is an unplugged event, and we so want you to know it. There will be opportunities for you to take photos after the ceremony is completed. Also, please note the ceremony is being recorded, so we ask that you work along with us as the ceremony continues. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Treat me not to leave thee, or to return from following after thee. For whither thou goest, I will go, and where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God my God. Wherever thou art buried, there will I be buried also.
For the Lord is so
to me, and also if all the death part thee and me. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
Thank you. Did it very well. Maciah Morgan. Marriage is a sacred relationship and should not be entered upon lightly or unprayerfully. The Apostle Paul helps us to see this sacredness of marriage by comparing the relationship of a husband and a wife to that of Christ and his church. Maciah says to the husbands, husbands, love your wives even as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. Maciah, there is no greater love in all the world than the love Jesus demonstrated when he died on the cross for us. This is the way the Bible says you are to love your wife. And if you will do that, it will bring more joy and fulfillment into your life than any other human relationship you will ever have. And Morgan, he says to the wife, he says, wives, submit yourselves unto your husbands as unto the Lord.
And the word submit does not suggest just saying yes to everything. There's a negotiation with everything. I always say it's not like Edith Bunker.
All right, Archie.
That's not a submitted storm, but you, as your husband follows the Lord, so you follow him. Amen? The husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. This means knowing that you are to walk by your husband's side. You are to encourage him and to support him and help him in every possible way. And the two of you walking together and walking with the Lord will find in this relationship the fulfillment and the completeness God intended from the very beginning. I draw a comment with me. Ask you to face each other. Inasmuch as you have expressed a desire to be united in marriage, I'm going to ask you to take a vow that is made not only in the presence of your family and friends, but also in the presence of God. Look at your wife. Don't be loud to me. Do you, at the end of what I'm asking, you're going to say, I do. Amen?
Yes, sir.
Loudly.
Yes, sir.
Do you take this woman to be a lawfully wedded wife? And do you promise before God and these witnesses to love her, to comfort her, to honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her, so long as ye both shall live? Do you so promise?
I do!
That was good. That was good. I think they heard it.
After many years I've been performing this is the loudest one I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Morgan, do you take this man to be a lawfully wedded husband, and do you promise before God and these witnesses to love him, to comfort him, to honor and keep him in sickness and in health?
I do.
And
I was ready.
So she was ready. I put one little piece. And forsaking all of us, keep thee only unto him so long as ye both shall live.
I do.
Amen. You heard her?
Twice.
I did.
Give them a hand. They both said I do. My God, what do you present to the tomb of your love for Morgan? Beautiful ring. Notice the ring has no end. It's continuous. Means so long as you shall live. Amen? If you place the ring on her ring finger and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I love it. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods.
With all my worldly goods.
I do and thou.
I do and thou.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Good. Morgan, what do you present as a token of your love for Maciah? And a beautiful ring, no end, beginning to end. If you place down this ring finger, repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods.
And with all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Now we have the part that we move a little quickly on. So we're going to ask them to come and we have a scripture reading by Mrs. Joseph. Then we have a solo by Morgan and then another scripture. Will you please come?
Colossians 3:14. And all over the virtues put on love, which binds them all together in perfect peace.
Amen.
A reading from Ephesians chapter 5, verses 25 to 33. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In this same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself.
After all, no one ever hated their own body, but they fed and cared for their body, just as Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church.
However, each one of you must also love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. Amen.
Amen.
As a wife, God will bless into your hand right now these two young people who are about to walk a new world. God, when difficult days come, they will not work because you will be with them, to lead them, to guide them, and to protect them. Surround them with your angels on a daily basis through God. Have them not to fear, not to worry, but to know that in spite of it all, you are their God and they will never fail. We thank you and praise you. We lift up the parents, the grandparents, cousins, all our relatives. May your Holy Spirit just be with this whole family, we pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Now, by the powers vested in me, by the state of Texas, and as a minister of the gospel, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife. What therefore, what therefore God has joined together, let not man put asunder. It comes to that point in time when I'll allow you to face your bride and you're allowed to have your first kiss. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Long. Thank you. We're going to ask you all to go to the reception hall now, and the family members are going to remain at your picture station. Everyone else, if you please go to the reception hall. Thank you so much. Thank you.